in this season.
As for the Saskatchewan Huskies, again, the defending champs, they as well are, you know, what a treat to watch they are. And going to be interesting to see if these UBC big men can hang with Saskatchewan. It's kind of a difference. Saskatchewan kind of has Leafers and Unsworth, big boys, whereas UBC kind of had long and athletic with guys like Baines and Burke. I tell you what, one of my favorite players of the tournament has been Kamara Burke. He's really special.
Burke has definitely stepped up and just surprised, I think, some other teams with his shooting and being able to step out to the three-point line, drain a shot when it's really needed to. I think there's a difference. I mean, any three-point in any of these games is huge, but it just feels like when Kamara Burke hits one, it's a very timely shot all the time, and he's got great shot selection and a great shot. And he's been huge for UBC in this weekend.
You don't see many players like that sticking with Burke, a guy who can be so physical, so strong, but at the same time, polished in the way he goes about the game.
He's a very talented player, and again, interesting to see how folks are going to match up in the post. And Leifer is an unusual post for the Huskies, someone who manages to be so effective and pretty quick, and will throw out a dunk and just sort of jump up when you least expect it and throw down a dunk. And so it'll be great to see who manages to battle down low, get position, and score some big two-pointers.
Well, they're announcing the starters now. These are two teams who know each other very well. Again, they've had a lot of battles this year in the Canada West, and you got your coaches coming together right now. Kevin Hansen, he has been one of the it's his team. You know, they just the big storyline coming in. They were the number one seed, and they looked a little sluggish against Acadia early on. Then pulled together, looked very confident.
Yep.
But last night against Trinity Western, the Spartans just really kind of took control of that game against UBC down the stretch.
And I don't think you can feel bad about losing a game to the Spartans. UBC is a team that has dominated the Spartans in past, but the Spartans team is a team that came well prepared to play and to compete. They took full advantage of their talent, which is clearly their big men, and rose to the occasion in a tough game against UBC and managed to come away with a win.
Well, Nathan, you just announced he is a big-time player off the bench for this UBC team. He plays starters minutes and a high score from Prince George, BC. And we just did a Dalhousie game with those Tigers who had a bunch of graduating seniors. And watching a UBC team that's going to say goodbye to some players as well, Malish, Murphy, White. So this is the last game for some proud Thunderbirds as well.
And experience plays such a huge key role in these games where they're so evenly matched and there's a lot on the line. The experience and the grit of 50-year players that just say, hey, I know this is my last game, this is my last shot, to really have this sort of exhilarating feeling of playing at this level. They're going to bring all of their previous years of experience to the table and a huge edge and determination to win it. And UBC has made so many, both of these teams actually have just come to the Nationals so many times, have so much experience, and UBC just has so many veterans who have this previous experience. So this is not routine for them, but they know how to get it done here.
One of our favorite players announced a few seconds ago, Alex Murphy, the point guard for UBC. He was incredible last night, crossing over on Horner at various times of Trinity Western, a scrappy point guard who can shoot it as well.
And it's so important to be able to have full faith in your ball handler. In tough games like this, there's going to guaranteed we're going to see some pressure, some ball pressure, or some full court pressing coming in. Different teams try and give different defensive looks to throw a wrench in the other team's plans. And you got to have full confidence in your point guard, and it's got to be a really strong key component of any team.
Love this matchup right here. Michael Leifers, big-time post player, and Kamara Burke, special talent. Michael Leifers in the Dalhousie game, with the highly anticipated Dal game. Both Sandy Veit and Joe Scow really had trouble with Michael Leifers. He provided a dynamic that I don't think Joe and Sandy saw all year long.
Right. Incredibly difficult guy to guard. Somehow just, again, manages to find the basket, sort of posts up strong, and then all of a sudden is just really good at cutting, finding the open hole, and a very intelligent basketball player who sees the court, has a high basketball IQ, and is just extremely effective and managed to play well. So he's going to be both Burke and Leifers are going to be huge components down low for both of these teams.
Well, here we go. These two Canwest powers are on the floor. The number one seed, UBC, and the number three seed and defending champions, Saskatchewan Huskies. They will not go back-to-back this year. But following up a national championship with a bronze medal, again, nothing to sniff at. And UBC as well, certainly a bronze medal would be a nice way for these outstanding group of seniors to go out.
For sure.
Saskatchewan in the green, well, UBC in the white and blue. Doug Plum is on the floor as well. He's one of our favorites of the weekend. And there's your matchup. Leapers and Burke, and it is won by Burke. And right away, here's a shot up for Saskatchewan. That one comes up short. That is Nerdahl. Back his way, Alex Murphy up here to Kamar Burke. Burke can do it all in the full court. And there you go, right away, Burke getting to work.
Burke getting to work indeed. And dribbling and finishing like that is a huge, huge asset from a post.
Hello out there to everybody watching. And make sure you send us off an email at tigerswebcast@gmail.com. Tigerswebcast@gmail.com. Kamar Burke. Hello out there to Peter Spur, watching, having breakfast, watching this game. And he was the first guy who told me on the emails that Kamar Burke was a guy to watch out for. And speaking of talented players, Jamal Barrett, everybody in Halifax this weekend talking about Jamal Barrett.
Yeah, just such a talented, well-rounded player, leading Canada West in assists and scoring and so much more. So just a great all-over player in Barrett.
There's Murphy and you. Nathan comes around that screen by Burke. It's picked up by Leifers. Over the top, but Leifers comes up short. And that is going to be white ball. So UBC will hold on to that.
Already such a fast-paced game, and both of these teams are coming out more focused than we've seen a lot of teams start off games initially so far this in this weekend. And they're just starting out really crisp, they're ready to play, and this is going to be a game of fine execution.
That is Murphy gets cut off. Burke, great-looking pass down for Plum, and he's got it to go. So we're seeing the full array of talent so far by Burke, shooting and passing here.
For sure. And Plum is such a tank down low, will just drive through people to the basket to get his 2 points.
Hello there to Cody Hedman, big UBC fan. I know you're watching, Cody. UBC law student. And Josh White as well, not starting here for the Thunderbirds, but we can expect to see Josh White at any moment.
For sure. Josh White will provide that extra zing for UBC when he gets out on the floor and brings his great court sense out for his team.
And I'm sure the boys at Mahoney's Pub probably are not watching us today, but if you are, I'm not sure if you're at the pub at 9:30, unless they offer some type of brunch. But if you are, hello out there to all our friends at Mahoney's Pub. Swung around there for Saskatchewan. Rudell. And went off the back of you, that crisp pass, but right back into the hands of Barrett. And now Saskatchewan, a little bit of confusion here. Nerdahl comes up short. Rajon Shabbat out there with the shave. He had the big-time beard going on all weekend, but now Shabbat out there clean-shaven.
Sometimes playoff beards not just for hockey, Bill.
Malish getting started. Nice little turnaround there for Malish.
What we're seeing here with these good teams is anyone on the court who's getting minutes is fully capable of scoring, and you can't slack off of anyone out here.
That is Barrett, picked up by Malish. Quick with a crossover dribble and into the lane. Misses that, but an athletic tip in there by Brudel. Well done. Heads up here. Nathan Yu takes it himself for two.
Nathan Yu capitalizing on a little bit of a slow get back there from the Huskies.
So athleticism in spades here in the early going. Again, you know, we knew out here in the AUS, we knew that the Can West, we heard about these Can West teams, but I tell you what, all of the Halifax basketball fans, they are talking about these incredible Can West talented teams. On cue, Kamar Burke. Wow. But yeah, that's really been the talk of the tournament, the athleticism of these Can West teams.
It's definitely a tough conference. There's nothing but good teams out there, and they've got to play each other all year long. So they've definitely a lot of talent, and you know, people are charging hard today.
So Kamar Burke takes the offensive foul. That is on Nerdahl, his first foul of the game. 14-6 here in the early going for UBC with 6:45 left. And there is the big flush by Burke. All he's done so far is scored 6 points, had a beautiful assist, and taken a charge. And we're 3 minutes in.
Not a bad game. I mean, some people would be happy if those were their stats for the whole game. So Burke is off to an early start.
TigersWebcast@gmail.com. Friends, again, remember, TigersWebcast@gmail.com. Comments, opinions, shouts out, critiques. Nathan Yu for two. And 16-6, check that. The early run here for UBC.
Nathan Yu showcasing his talent and showing how dynamic and how quick, using his quickness to shoot over the Huskies.
We got a foul here on the Thunderbirds. So Jamal Barrett will go to the line. We got a timeout for Saskatchewan. Barry Rollick's going to call a timeout here and kind of get things settled down. 16-6 at the moment, but I would not count on this getting too much separation happening, Cooper. I got a feeling we're watching a game that's probably going to come down to the wire here.
I totally agree with you, Bill. This UBC team has been out-executing the Huskies so far, but we expect that post-timeout that the Huskies are going to be able to come back with a little more settled and be able to execute a little bit better. This has just been a high-tempo game so far. Both teams having good looks. And UBC just, especially Nathan Yu and Burke, jumping out there and just capitalizing, just having a little bit more, you know. And again, Kamar Burke, just so hard to guard overall. You've got to have someone big on him because he'll post you up. And you've got to have someone quick, otherwise he'll draw you out and shoot a three over your head. So just a dynamic player that's been a huge factor in these early minutes of this game.
Well, you want to talk about some tough guys who did not go out easy in those semifinals. Kamar Burke had 15 rebounds and 13 points. Murphy, the senior, had 21 for UBC. And the backcourt combination of Shabbat and Barrett had 54 points combined.
Wow.
So they did not go down easy, these guys.
Yeah, by no means. And just as this game was getting started off, these teams are teams who have played each other plenty over the years, and you could just see everyone shaking hands, and they're both really respectful of the other team's talent. So it's a hard fight tonight, but with a lot of respect as well.
Kamar Burke out there with Mayotte. He's on the floor now. Alex Murphy going to work down the block there. Comes up short on that one.
Great pass by Burke. We talk about how hard it is to pass through the key, and Burke made that one happen.
There's the big boy, Unsworth.
Unsworth getting on the board here for the Huskies, and they're going to need him to keep up with Burke and to score some of his own here for his team.
I was live blogging last night, and I said, this Unsworth kid, he'd walk by us here at the scorer's table. And I said, this Unsworth kid is huge. And a Saskatchewan fan blogged back, you should see his brother. So I couldn't imagine anybody being bigger than that guy. From Maple Creek, Saskatchewan, the fourth-year senior.
Yeah, it's just big boys, and they're showing a lot of athleticism, too. He's got a good quickness, and it's a tough job keeping up with Burke. So huge athletic bigs here on both teams.
Heads up. Did you see that pass? The behind-the-back pass that leads to a shot for you. Little baseline drift pass from behind his back for Alex Murphy. So, and again, Cooper, we've been talking about this as we've been doing these games ever since the quarterfinals. There's a little turnaround for Burke that he finally misses on. The beauty about a game like this is that you're still playing to win, but at the same time, players relax a bit and they start doing some fun things.
Yep, it's not like your life is on the line here. People are having fun and we're all smiles and warm-up, and you get to see beautiful plays like that, Bill.
On cue.
Little dipsy-do, dunkaroo. Yep. Not bad at all.
Murphy to Mayotte, finger roll, and 18-10 here for UBC. And now UBC is starting to put it on here. But I turned it over with Unsworth.
All right, Unsworth gets it back. Nice steal there from UBC's Nixon, who's a freshman who gets good minutes on this veteran team, which is a testament to his skill for sure.
He'll be one of the guys next year heavily relied on by UBC with all these graduation seniors. And there's Duncan Jones. He had a couple of early threes last night. Kind of cooled off, eventually fouled out.
Well, he's making his presence be known here today.
While fouling out in last night's game, we got a hockey turn or a hockey change coming up for Saskatchewan. They have
they're
five,
coming over the boards.
Five fresh green shirts coming off the boards, being led by Nolan Brudel.
Yep. Nolan Brudel is a huge offensive contributor for this Huskies team, putting up big numbers and a lot of minutes for the team. So he'll be leading the charge for this five new guys on the court.
So Holman over there to Nerdahl. And nicely done down here. Michael Leifers for two.
Leifers, again, great positioning. Wonderful, wonderful positioning. Makes it work.
Right back this way, the youngster Nixon. And 22-13 for UBC.
UBC always has the answer so far to what the Huskies are putting up. So Huskies have to look to get good stops as well.
Nathan Yu with a turnover and now in transition with Graham Bath. And a little bit of a soft pass there for Bath. He's going to try the 15-footer and comes up way short. Bath has been a lot of fun to watch this weekend. If you like guys stirring it up, he's had a couple of hard fouls on Owen Claussen. on Friday, and then him and Jacob Dirksen had some interesting get-togethers yesterday as well.
A little bit of a basketball enforcer, are you hinting at that? Yeah, it's always, we always say, if you think this is a non-contact game, you're fooling yourself. Go play golf if you're looking for non-contact. Basketball can get a little rough sometimes.
And this is Baines into the game here for UBC. Bath will have a seat. So they're coming in and out here as the player, you know, and the coaches too. In a game like this, you want to try to win, but you also want to, you know, get some kids checked into a tournament game.
Yep. It's a huge opportunity for younger players to get some playing experience against some of the best teams. These guys have played each other lots already, but it's a different look when it's at a national weekend.
There's Baines grabbing that rebound. Nice play there by Baines, but then Mayotte. I don't think Mayotte. That was a weird play, a big dunk by Brudel, but that ball, Mayotte just let it go past him for some reason, and Brudel picked it up and said, thank you very much.
Yeah, Brudel almost looked a little confused. And like, well, I guess I can dunk it if that's what you're looking for. And he did indeed dunk it.
22-15 for UBC, 2:56 left in the first quarter, just getting started here. And hello out there to everybody in Saskatoon and in Vancouver. Have you been to Saskatoon? I know I've been asking these
questions. I don't get out much, Bill, to be quite honest. I have not been to Saskatoon.
I spent a weekend once in Saskatoon, and it is good times.
It's good times?
Yeah, it's a great city. They got a nice, a really cool little downtown core.
Yep.
And the campus of Saskatchewan, beautiful. Just one of the most prettiest campuses I've seen.
Awesome.
So hello out there to all your friends in Saskatoon. There's Jamal Barrett up top. With Nathan, or at the Nixon, sorry, and Barrett got a finger in the eye. He's going to have to hand off.
Oh.
And they're going to call timeout here, or get timeout on the floor and let Barrett wince that off. Looks like he got a finger in the eye.
Yeah, that's no good. And Barrett, being such a huge, huge player for this Husky team, we want him to have both ocular components all in line so he can drain some threes and get some steals and have some assists, because he's actually the first all-time leader in all of those three categories in Canada West ever.
Leifer's a tough and one down there. So Leifer's on the board with an and one, and now he's got 5 points.
And the Huskies slowly creeping back into this game here, 17-22. Leifer is a huge part of that. Again, positioning is so key for how he is so effective. Fiennes manages to always be available to catch the ball and always does good things with it once he does catch it.
So 22-17 now for UBC, and look at the speed there. And that is off of Baines, though, so no luck there for Baines on that. He couldn't get his hands ready for that tricky pass from Jazz Gill, one of these first-year players again for UBC.
And again, if this is the crop of first-years coming in from UBC, we got a lot of fun games to look forward to in the future. Well, huge speed from Jazz Gill.
Well, there's Gill, the left-hander, coming up short on that shot. And again, Cooper, we talked about it in the Friday game, the first game, that, you know, what a treat that is for a first-year player to come in and kind of get groomed in playing behind a bunch of fourth- and fifth-year seniors.
If you can get the minutes on the court in the way that Nixon has over the course of the year, it's a huge opportunity to just be getting the great passes and the great looks and play with people who know the league and know the game so well and be part of a really great flow. And to take that learning opportunity and go on is great. And that's a position a lot of young players have to decide. Okay, am I going to go to a lesser program where I'm it? And I'm starting in my first year, and I'm all that. Or am I going to go and I'm going to learn from veteran players? And so that's a choice. Then there's goods and bads about both of those things. But Nixon's definitely fitting into the rotation well here at UBC.
And both these programs getting to the point now where they can walk into a young man's living room and say, hey, if you come play for me, chances are good you're going to be at the Metro Center, or you're going to be at Scotiabank Place in Ottawa,
right,
playing for championships.
Huge recruiting. Once you get the ball rolling on being a winning team, it's much easier to recruit for sure.
Well, here's Barrett off that alley-oop miss off the inbounds pass. Nice distance here by Brudel, showing nice variety in his game.
Brudel's definitely stepping up in this game and being a bit of the answer here for the Huskies as they clamber back into this.
So a fresh five coming in here for Saskatchewan. So they're going to go kind of St. Francis Xavier X-Women style, if you will.
Yeah,
congratulations
yeah.
to the X-Women again. Nicely knocked away there by you.
Overall good ball control there by Ben Baker, a freshman again for the Huskies. Confidence to grab the ball and go in transition against some tough competition.
Baker, the Saskatoon product, and now he has mentioned a fresh five in here with Nerdahl and Unsworth back out there again as well. Shabbat And this is Jazz Gill running the show here for UBC. A little handoff play there for Nathan Yu. Gets a screen from Baines. And a little elbow jump shot for Yu that comes up heavy and rebound there for Saskatchewan. Mm-hmm. Big David Newfield. Nerdall runs into Yu, and Yu's going to get a foul on the floor on that call. Go ahead, Cooper.
I was just saying, great ball movement overall. This is a high-tempo game, and both teams are really executing their offense well. It's been a lot of fun to watch, and we're not seeing teams sort of struggle in the way we've seen in some other games in this weekend.
So four team fouls here on UBC, 22-21, 1:33 left in the first quarter. Doug Plum will check back in here, and Nathan, you will sit. And to the far side of your screen here, you have Rajan Shabbat about to inbounds for Saskatchewan. Again, the clean-shaven Shabbat.
No playoff beard anymore.
No.
Still got the fancy sneakers, though. Those bright green sneakers, you always know.
And how about the runner off the backboard by Shabbat?
Nice take there.
And Saskatchewan has their first lead in a long time. A nice little 8-point run here for Saskatchewan.
These are back-and-forth teams, and it's not going to be an easy win for either one.
There's Kamar Burke spinning on Unsworth for two. Kamar Burke.
He was demonstrating he could go any which way he wanted to on that move. A lot of athleticism in the air on that guy.
So 8 points for Burke, the Mississauga native. Unsworth, a little kick out here for Nerdall. Short and brought down by Burke. So both ends again for Kamara. And now the great pass and Mayotte for two. And a 4-point run by UBC now.
UBC seems to be doing better in transition and catching the Huskies off guard.
Back and forth we go. Barrett for two for Saskatchewan. 26-25, and these teams starting to get their swagger on here as we approach the end of the first quarter.
It's always kind of fun to watch teams get their swagger on, Bill.
Kamara Burke for three, and Burke is becoming the storyline of the game. 11 points so far, doing it on both ends.
If it hasn't been in transition or from Carl or from you, it's coming from Burke.
And now Nerdall, the response, and heads up now, friends. Sit back and enjoy out there in Saskatoon and Vancouver. We got a good game going on.
And with 7 seconds left, it's been intense.
This is Doug Plum. Mayotte, Burke for three, heavy. And that will do it for the first quarter. What a great first quarter of bronze medal action here in Halifax, 29-28. As walking right past us here is Kamar Burke. And Burke's at 11. And Emma Cooper in a pretty good first quarter played by a lot of good players. Kamar Burke really kind of stood out there.
He's definitely the shining light in this first quarter, and he's just doing it, making himself really available at the three-point line, and he's such a dynamic player when you can go in and post up, and you can drift out to the three-point line and guaranteed hit a shot. It's a hugely hard challenge for another team to guard. He's been playing very aggressively and very well so far, and his teammates also deserve credit in also making sure to get him the ball and set him up, and they made sure that he was the one taking the last shot there, and they know he's on fire. So again, an experienced team will know who's got it going on right now. It's clearly Burke, and they're making sure he's the one having the opportunities so that they can capitalize on it as a team.
Meanwhile, for Saskatchewan, kind of a balanced attack right there. They got a three from Nerdall, a tough two from Shabbat. 5 points from Leafers, 6 points from Barrett. So Saskatchewan with that five-in, five-out substitution pattern, they're kind of going at them with numbers right now.
They are going at them with numbers. It's a little bit of the middle school substitution style, but it seems to be working for them, and definitely more of an even spread in terms of who's scoring. People are catching UBC off guard as well. I do think one thing they've got to start being aware of is UBC is kicking their butts in transition. This is a great team, and they've got no business letting UBC run down the court to get an easy, uncontested layup in transition. Although, to UBC's credit, they are doing a really great job seeing the whole court, having someone really sprint down hard. But the Huskies do have to pick up their socks and cut that short.
One of my favorite things of the tournament has been the Saskatchewan fans here behind us, always with the flag waving and clapping the thunder sticks.
That's right.
They've been a great part of this weekend.
Not to mention the cowboy hats, Bill. Let's not forget the cowboy hats. We're seeing the different regional things come out. I think we're listening to some East Coast music here while we're in the Metro Center. We had some cowboy hats behind us. In the last game against Lakehead, we had the Lakehead fans in spandex, the guys in spandex, which is always hilarious. So it's just a lot of fun here this weekend so far.
TigersWebcast@gmail.com. Hope to hear from you at some point throughout the broadcast. 29-28 here for UBC over the Huskies as we start our second quarter. One of the things I've always really respected about the Huskies, Saskatchewan, over the years, just looking at the rosters here and there, the first thing is when you look at hometowns, the first thing that sticks out at you is SK at the end of each name.
It's true.
They brought in some recruits from, with Barrett from the States and Jones from Calgary. But for the most part, you got Saskatchewan homegrown products right there on the team.
Yeah, and Unsworth from Maple Creek, Saskatchewan. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's great. No, they're homegrown talents, and it's great. It's great when you can build a program around people who are, happy to stay close to home and excited to play great basketball there.
Well, Shabbat's going to get an assist on that, but he just lost control on the three-pointer, and Leafers picked it up and laid it in. So Leafers and Shabbat sharing a laugh on that play.
Leafers is always effective out there.
Doug Plum, he's been a fun guy to watch. Big-time defender, physical, nice little elbow jumper there. In that UBC-Acadia game, down the stretch, he was really too much for the youthful Acadia guards.
He's a tough guy. He's built solid, and he was cruising through some of the smaller, younger guys who don't have as much meat on their bones. Mm. We're saying some of the versus UBC, Acadia looked like they were shy 20 pounds on every guy, man-to-man. And Doug Plum took advantage of that and just charged hard and made some good buckets.
And as we mentioned in our previous game, congratulations again to that Acadia team. You want to talk about a team that really brought it on. They won made it in the AUS, and they pushed UBC through three quarters before eventually kind of getting worn down. Mm-hmm. Nothing to hang their heads about. That's a young team full of second and third year talent.
Yeah.
They'll be right back in the mix next year. Mm-hmm. And I can't wait on Tuesday morning to wear my Owen Clausen t-shirt.
For sure.
On the AUS sports show. So you Clausen fans, make sure you keep an eye out for that.
Huge block there. Nicely done by the Huskies. And this has been back and forth. And wonderful pop back by Brent Malish on the other end there for UBC.
Well, here comes Shabbat in the middle of the floor in transition through Mayett and Plum. And that is going to be on Mayett.
And we've got a whole other crop of Huskies coming up doing the sub. We're just subbing three, not five this time. But to keep the high tempo of the game going seems to be the philosophy that there's going to be lots of subs. Everyone's going to get some minutes, and everyone's expected to perform here.
Well, first-year player Andrew Henry into the game, first-year player from Regina. So hello to the Henrys. Your son is checked in to a bronze medal game. Ben Baker out there as well. Kabar Burke nearly has a steal picked up by Nerdahl. And now some numbers for Saskatchewan. That is Baker over there on the near side. And up top for Henry, he's got his first touch.
Mm-hmm. Kamara is, Burke's playing some tough defense and putting a lot of pressure on the ball at the top there.
Henry, shot clock winding down, gives it to Nerdahl, and he gets blocked right in the middle there by Malish.
UBC showing a little bit of experience and domination there on that defensive play.
A foul here on Alex Murphy, so Murphy will go to the line for two. And 34-32 again, 7:57 left in your second quarter.
Could be my imagination, but I do see this UBC team really having a little bit of extra spurt, a little bit of extra energy over the Huskies. They're more willing to get down there quickly offensively in transition or just more effective about it, I could say. And it's almost the difference that we've seen in the Huskies when they played earlier. We say they had the extra step on the other teams, and they were sort of the ones doing that. And it seems like the tables are getting turned a little bit on them in this game.
Coming up for your halftime entertainment, we have Arman Alawalia, the local writer with the Dalhousie Gazette, an outstanding young basketball analyst. And there's Burke nearly creating that steal again. Nicely done here by Brudel, and Leafers with the big flush. Partner post passing and an alley-oop dunk.
I don't know how Leafers does that. He just jumps up so high. It doesn't look like he has to gather that much, and is a great, great pass to get it into him up there.
Well, we said on Friday, there's some athletes who kind of have to gather themselves and other guys who can just springboard. Leafers is one of those guys. He's just up. He doesn't have to gather himself in any way, shape, or form.
Mm-hmm. And I think it's actually reported that Leafers actually has kangaroo in his family, so he comes spring-loaded. Little joke there. Being goofy here on SSN.
You keep that goofiness to yourself, pal. Yeah. I'll get Hugh Mullally over here in
That's
no
right.
time.
That's right.
He checked in for you there in that fifth medal game.
That's right.
Or a fifth place game. The Saskatchewan right back to work here. That one heavy, and Kamar Burke cannot quite control. Newfield had that shot. And now back to Sway. Doug Plum in transition. Good push here. Murphy will get a shot over Barrett. And Barrett for three. And I tell you what, last night, Cooper, Barrett Or Murphy for three. I mean, and last night Murphy was special in that crossover. He had a horner of Trinity Western just absolutely in knots last night.
And we can see why. With that that three was a fadeaway, and it was contested, and he made it look easy, and that's not an easy shot by any means.
Murphy had 34 points in the Canwest final, 21 for 22 from the foul line. The fifth-year senior leading his team to a Canwest championship.
Just so much talent. You can't say enough about the players on both of these teams, and you know, it's individual talent, and they're both special teams because of how well that they're playing together throughout the year and in this game as well. So it's great to see the passing and the team play that we're seeing here today.
TigersWebcast@gmail.com. TigersWebcast@gmail.com. And we got a technical foul coming up here on Saskatchewan.
And we haven't seen too many of those technicals handed out so far this weekend, Bill, but we can definitely have a swing here as the Huskies are only down 4 points.
It is Jamel Barrett, and you want Cooper? I don't remember a technical foul yet. That might be the first one. Mm-hmm. I honestly don't remember one in games that we've done.
There was the foul in the game, the intentional foul against Simon Farine, just in that last game that we did, and it was against Dalhousie, which also was a tough call, but I don't know that we've seen a tactical. So
one down for Alex Murphy. UBC with a little bit of separation here, 6:40 left in the second quarter. Two down for Murphy, and now 6 points to lead, as I mentioned. And so UBC, some separation, and we got
another technical.
Another technical foul.
Wow.
On the head coach, Barry Rolick. So Rolick now with a technical as well.
Oh, man. That's a tough call, and Huskies obviously not too pleased about this turnaround. This can just have a huge turnaround for the point spread here.
Well, I don't know what Barry Rolick said, because he's on the other end. But I tell you what, some of the things that because we're right at the midway point here of the scorer's table. We're like 10 feet off to the left.
Right.
And some of the things I've heard coaches say to referees this weekend and not get teed up. I don't know what Barry Rolick said, but.
It's clearly unrepeatable on this sportscast if you got a T for it.
Or maybe it's an official who's just had enough of the weekend. Because, I mean, the officials have taken a barrage from coaches this weekend.
There's been a lot of close games and a lot of line on the line here for the team. So hats off to the officials for sticking out through these. These are tough games to officiate.
Great play. Plum doesn't get it, but Baines with a follow. Nice backdoor cut.
We've been seeing some pretty, pretty nice backdoor cuts this weekend, Bill.
So 10 points to lead. So, Cooper, that is a 8-point trip for UBC on the two technicals and the dunk. So that's not a bad trip down
not
on the...
Not a bad that, trip at all.
Yeah, and right back this way, Murphy. Thought he had Baines, but gets through all the way to Burke. And Murphy for three, and now a big-time run for UBC, and they lead by 13.
UBC is all smiles, and they're looking really confident out there. They're looking like they're having a lot of fun. They've got the energy and the time to make these sort of finesse passes. They're looking pretty strong right now.
Big time trouble now for Saskatchewan. 6 minutes left in the second quarter. Burke for three, heavy, and rebounded by Unsworth. And that would have brought the UBC bench off their feet had that gone. Barrett looking for the response. He's short. Jamal not quite feeling it here tonight.
You know, you got to think that the Huskies are going to want to get out on Burke. He can't make every shot, but that's not the guy you want to leave alone at the 3-point line at this point.
Murphy with Unsworth on him. How about that matchup?
A little bit of a size differential there.
And now Murphy comes clean for three, and he's got it. And this is a 14-point run for UBC.
Huskies just, they're going to look to Barrett now to just settle them down and to set up their offense and make it happen here. He's the guy who's going to dig down for this team and get it going.
Barrett quick gets a block here on Nixon.
Just at the sharp intake, because Barrett looked like he just got a really harsh elbow in the nose there. It just looked like a hard foul. You see it on the replay there. He got up. He looks okay, but that maybe from our angle, that looked worse than it was.
Well, it's been a rough day for Jamel. A few minutes ago, he got the finger in the eye. He had to kind of shake that off, and a tentacle, and now this. So
he's playing tough in a tough game for sure.
So Barrett stems the tide for the moment. That foul on Nixon. And he will have two shots, misses one. So untimely miss there for Jamel. First one down for Barrett. or second one down, I should say. And now with exactly 5 minutes left, Graham Bath will check back in for UBC. And Saskatchewan with three new players out here as well. We used the X-Women reference earlier because out here in the AUS, the St. Francis Xavier X-Women just substitute non-stop throughout the game. They just come at you in a big blue wave.
And they just run. Yeah. And it's the object we assume is to tire the other team out, and it works pretty well.
Well, congratulations to those X-Women. They beat Alberta. Mm-hmm. That is a huge win. An AUS team beating a Can-West team.
Yeah, no, it's the same story for men and women's basketball. Mm. Canada West is tough for both. Doesn't matter what gender you are.
Especially in women's, though. Well, yeah, they've won 20 straight bronze babies or something like that.
No, it's intense.
Doug Plum, great pass. Nixon and a nice hustle there by Tim Hallman to get back on that.
That was a nice hustle. It almost looked like it might have been clean, but he's going to get the call. Or he's going to get the foul for that.
4:26 left in the quarter, second half, or first half, I should say. And Arman Aluwalia coming up for your halftime entertainment. Foka, I tell you what, this young man, Arman Aluwalia, you're going to meet him at halftime, friends. He's a focused dude.
He is a focused dude.
I don't think I've ever met a young, budding sports journalist as focused as he is.
He's got all the numbers in his head, and he's doing everything. I think, what is it? He got cut off from Twitter for tweeting too much. Like, he exceeded the number of allowable tweets trying to get all the word out about what's going on this weekend out to the masses. So if that's not dedication, I don't know what is.
Nicely done there by Baines to get that away from Leafers. And now 12 seconds on the shot clock, and that was not a trip to remember for Leafers. And now a foul on Hallman.
It's a dedication on Leafers' part to get those rebounds and to keep being scrappy. But the game is just not going in the Huskies' favor right now. The energy and the momentum is not in their favor. So they're going to have to simmer down here, look to get a basket and a stop, and then go from there.
Of course, the problem here right now for the Huskies, players would say, because players are always obviously never like to get subbed out. So they would say, oh, I can't get into a groove. And, maybe some Huskies players starting to feel like they just can't get into a groove here with this constant subbing. But
That's a potential.
But I think that's just a player.
It's just a player thing. Yeah, you got to be able to work with whatever the coach is going with and play your best for sure.
Beautiful high-low passing with Bath and Baines, and another two for UBC.
UBC is looking comfortable so far in this game, and there's not too much the Huskies are throwing at them that they haven't been able to counteract.
Nice cut. Leifer had a lane to the basket, but kicks it back out to Brudel, and now a wide-open look for Leifer. No mistake.
Can I just say that was beautiful passing, Bill?
Yeah, it really was.
There's no fancy metaphor for that. That was pretty.
Well, Leifer's in his fourth year, and I hope he comes back for his fifth, because I could watch a kid like that all day.
For sure.
That is Bath. A little foul line jumper. He's got it to go. So nice shot there by Graham Bath, contributing.
Every time the Huskies seem to score, UBC seems to be able to come back and score within 10 seconds. It's this really quick turnaround, so Huskies have got to be able to dig down and get a stop as well.
Nice layup, Jamel Barrett. And nice the turnover now, Shabbat. They're wrapped up there with Baines, and they get to the go. So Barrett and Shabbat starting to influence the game here.
Well done. I think Barrett might have been looking for the foul there as well, but a great, great effort there to get the two or the 4 points that quickly.
And now Barrett just ran into a wall in Grand Bath on that screen. So Jamel, this is not a game to remember for him. He's getting beat up.
No, he's definitely getting hit, and that's a technique that some people will use. When you are the go-to guy, people have got you the target on the back. And other coaches were saying about being able to put up numbers when you're the go-to guy, to be able to have to consistently score and consistently get assists and rebounds in a game is even more impressive when everyone's making a concerted effort to stop you particularly.
There's a wide open baseline. Look for Malish, and he's got it down. 57-41 for UBC.
No one's missing today, I think.
No.
That's my analysis.
That's true, Cooper. We're not. It's only 2 minutes left in the first half. One. So I guess if you're Saskatchewan, you just say, hey, come on, hang in there. At some point, they got to start to miss shots.
And that's true, and it's hard. The dying minutes of the game, it's just so hard to keep that shot percentage up.
Baker, the freshman, up here for Saskatchewan. Mayotte on him. Tough defense there by Mayotte. Barrett. And a great look there by Duncan Jones. He's hit some big threes this weekend. He's got another one to go.
Jones has been a big part of this Huskies team, and he's chipping in there with some points.
So Duncan, and 57-44. Saskatchewan starting to claw away. Malish misses and a board by Brudel. And now here come the Huskies. Starting to chip away at this thing.
Yeah, just look, starting to look a little more confident, like you say, Bill.
Duncan Jones, heavy. And brought down by Murphy. Good hustle play there by Mayotte to keep it alive. Oh, Murphy thought he had a wide open Malish, but taken away by Brudel. Brudel's got nice, quick, long arms in. In the open floor, maybe not Leafers game.
Maybe not. That's I was feeling a little bit of empathy for Leafers there because when I played, if I was to get the ball in transition like that, it was a guaranteed travel for sure. So I'm not sure if Leafers was expecting to get the transition pass or not there.
Hello out there to Sean Glover. Hope I'm saying your name right there, Mr. Glover. And it says, go Huskies no matter what. And props for Barry Rollick. Says that Barry, Coach Rollick did an outstanding job this year. So thanks very much for that email, Mr. Glover. Our first of the day. We had about 60 on Friday in our two games. And we've had about 10 so far between the Lakehead game and this game.
It's great when people check in and give us any feedback, any tips, or extra comments is always appreciated.
Tigerswebcast at gmail.com. There's Barrett and Murphy. Great matchup there. Barrett gets past Murphy and good help by Mayotte. And Leafers hits the deck. And Leafers and Barrett are looking very awkward right now. I'm not sure which one's hurt worse. I'm guessing it's Barrett considering the day he's had.
But he's laughing. This guy is a trooper. We gotta give a shout out to the Huskies just being a tough team right now. Barrett has got the Three Stooges eye poke today. He's gotten hit and all sorts of stuff, and he went down hard there. He's gonna get back up, and he still knows that he's a go-to scorer for his team, and it is riding on him a lot to sort of be able to set up the plays and be able to play hard, and he's ready to do it.
There's a wide open look for Brudel. UBC wasn't ready and just rimmed out. Even the ref went over and asked Barrett if he was okay. I think even the refs are starting to feel bad for him. And now they call him on a foul.
Well, he was
ticky-tack.
He was pushing it a little in transition there. I mean, you do have to be careful when you dribble ahead of someone. It's easy as a defender to sort of get that ticky-tacky foul.
And that's his third. So there's a storyline for you, Huskies fans. Mm-hmm. Three fouls now on Barrett.
It's always tough when that someone gets their third foul in the first half. Mm-hmm. So even if you get it like right at the start of the third quarter, it's different somehow. It's mentally different, I think.
Well, the technical didn't help. And so now he'll have to sit for a while, mm-hmm. at least for the rest of the half. 46 seconds left in the half. And 62-44 for UBC. They've got some good separation here. Saskatchewan's looking better, but UBC seems to have an answer every time.
It's true.
Nice job here. Great strip by you on Leafers. And in transition, Murphy over the top of Henry takes himself for two. And a 20-point lead for UBC.
UBC has been unbelievable in transition so far this game. And I would have to say that is the biggest difference here between these two teams right now.
High post entry. Nice post passing there with Leafers and Brudel. And going to get a foul here. I think it's on the floor, though. Mm-hmm.
Does UBC in transition, they're making some really tough passes look really great, and you've just got it. You can almost see that they've been working on this in practice all the time, just running really wide, whoever's going down, and cutting in hard, and the passes they're making are unbelievable.
That would have been a long two for Shabbat, but rims out. Nice weak side rebound by Henry, and now Nerdahl, he's heavy. And it is to Saskatchewan. 8 seconds left in the half, and it'll be Saskatchewan ball.
Saskatchewan looking a little sloppy just as we close off this half here. Just a quick shot selection. Oh, never mind.
What a beautiful inbounds play. And that was Brudel who got a finger on it to lay it in.
That's right.
Murphy short. So a chance for Saskatchewan to build here.
Yep.
That was a great looking play right there. They got Brudel going. But UBC, and this is not a mistake, 64 points in the first half UBC. 46 for Saskatchewan, and as we just alluded to a couple minutes ago, Cooper, if you're Barry Rollick, you just got to say, guys, come on, they can't keep going like this the entire game. They're not going to put up 130 on us.
Exactly.
So let's just keep working hard, and they'll start missing shots.
You could definitely say that as a coach, and you're going to, I think players, or once the coach will say that, they'll know that as well. UBC's had an unreasonably amazing shooting, which is great for them. they've also had great shots in, or great layups in transition, and that's something that the Huskies can definitely control. They can make the effort to have, you've got to send someone back. As a post player, you've got to be able to sort of get in there and rebound and then see it and get back as well. So you really, that's something that they can control. That's an effort thing. That's a seeing the court and a whole sort of basketball IQ thing. They've got to get on that, because there's no way at this level that there should be that many transition plays by UBC.
I am going to get my flip cam ready here, because a friend of mine, these guys were at the Dalplex a while, or at the Metro Center last weekend for the AUS Championships, these skippers. This is an incredible show, and she wants me to make sure I get one of these people on the video. I can't remember which one.
All right, so we've got Jump Energy, which is a team of jump rope athletes who are going to be performing right here at halftime. So that's great entertainment.
Too bad they don't have it on the screen.
Yeah, but, it'll be kind of fun.
Oh, well.
So we're just going to tease everyone who's not here, like, this is an amazing halftime show. It's so good.
So, friends, if you're looking for something to do here in the next 13 minutes, make sure you send us an off email, tigerswebcast@gmail.com. And, again, that was the thing about the bronze medal game is that both teams are, you know, getting after it. They want to win.
Yep.
But not maybe quite as tight as they would normally be when there's so much on the line. So what you get is a lot of beautiful basketball plays. And there was anywhere from 5 to 6 gorgeous plays in that half.
For sure. And then keep talking about those transition passes that you and others are making down, just long, long ball passes that were exactly where they needed to be to make for, you know, not highlight reel plays, but just gorgeous layups. So great assists, too.
And now the big turning point, you know, as hot as UBC was from the field, really, if you're Saskatchewan, when you say, hey, look, you know what, if we don't get those 2 technical fouls and give up a 3...
Right.
Or give up a dunk, then we're right in this thing. And that's pretty much what happened. They had one trip for UBC where they scored 6 points with 4 foul shots and a dunk.
Right. And, you know, they are a good team. The Huskies can get back into this, and that's the end of the day. They're more than capable of doing that. There's a few basic things that they have to be able to stop transition, have to assume that the shots are going to cool off, and they have to be able to execute a little more. I mean, if they're going to get back into this again, it's starting. Their UBC is more than starting to pull away. They're going to have some of their shots fall too. At this point, the Huskies are really going to have to rely. You know, Barrett's been doing a heck of a good job so far this game. We saw he's been quite a trooper there. He's been getting injured, and he's still pushing hard. But some of their shots are going to have to fall, and they're going to have to be able to count on their experienced guards to be able to hit an open 3 when it comes down to it.
Meanwhile, if you're Kevin Hansen, you're saying, look, guys, you know what? We came in here as the number 1 seed.
Right.
We were hoping for a championship, and it's not going to happen for us. But I read a great, great quote yesterday by Hansen. He said to his guys, look, tomorrow when we show up, I'm going to be coaching to win, so I hope you guys show up to play to win.
Yep.
And I think that's what we got so far from UBC.
Yeah, and it's exciting to see the level of play that they're bringing, and you can see why they're such a highly rated team. They're certainly doing a lot of things right. They've got everything from the good technical plays, the good passing, the good court vision, you know, those long passes down for transition, and just amazing shooters. And we've seen Burke step up early in the game. He's cooled off a little bit, but what a huge contributor to get UBC out in the lead initially. Big men is the theme of this weekend, is being able to post up and hit someone, and then being like, oh, okay, cool, I'll drain a 3 on your head as well. The versatility of some of these athletes is really, really outstanding, and it's been fun to watch them showcase what they've been working so hard on over the last 5 years.
Mm-hmm. Meanwhile, Cooper, we'll catch people up on the fifth place game that was just before us, if you didn't see it here on SSN Canada. A game that kind of started with both teams kind of going through the motions a little bit, but then in the second half, when it got down to winning time, the intensity really picked up and came down to a great run by Trinity or Lakehead. They went on an 8-point run to get back into it. And then Dalhousie seized control again, and they just had to inbound the ball with 12 seconds left in the half court. And Lakehead put out a really quick lineup.
Yep.
And they had 2 chances at it, knocked it out of bounds, and then on the third time got the turnover. And too many names going through my head. Greg Carter brought it down and got an assignment for him, got the intentional foul.
Yep.
And from there, Lakehead seized control.
Yep.
And that was really the play, but it was a really fun game to watch in terms of both teams kind of deciding late, hey, let's try to win this thing.
and it was a real effort. It was such an upset for Dowler, such a tough situation. But you got to hand it to Lakehead in terms of just gritty play, never giving up. And a lot of teams will say they're never giving up, but you could really see that Lakehead had full intentions to win it, even though they were in such a hugely tough position. And they pulled it out, and those are the exciting basketball games that people, you know, while you get good numbers out at the Metro Center, people just come to see good basketball, come to see that kind of play, and see people really hustle. And that's why a lot of people will choose to support college or university basketball over sometimes professional leagues, because you just get people who really care and people who are really willing to play with their heart on their sleeve, like you say.
Meanwhile, coming up in our next game, we got the gold medal game with Trinity Western and Carleton, and I'm not sure how much you've seen Carleton this week, but Trinity Western, you got to think that, you know, the coach was talking last night, and he said Jacob Dirksen hasn't even played his best game yet. So
that's almost a threat.
Yeah, but I tell you what, Tyson Hinds last night against Saskatchewan played really, really well. Mm-hmm. So you got to think it's probably going to come down to Tyson Hinds and Jacob Dirksen.
And that's a fair assessment. Those are marquee players, to be sure, on both of these teams. And it's been exciting to see Trinity Western play, because they've surpassed expectations, which is always exciting when that happens for a team. They've just played hugely well and used their advantages, clearly big men down low, being athletic and versatile. But to their guards' credit, they're definitely had amazing games, and the sort of teamwork and cohesion between the guards getting the ball down low and vice versa passing is really great to watch. You know, and Carleton has had some amazing games, and so it'll just be interesting to, like you say, see what Hintz and Dirksen bring to the table.
Well, Cooper, let's bring in Armand Alawalia.
Yep.
And we'll get his unique brand of analysis. Armand coming in.
All right. See you in a minute.
Cooper will be back here in about 7 minutes. We are at 7:44 left in the halftime. And hello out there to Vic Cadelsi. Thank you very much. For that email, and great point, Vic and Elsie talking about Saskatchewan and all that homegrown talent. Really a tribute to that program. Enjoying breakfast or enjoying the broadcast while eating breakfast, and that's the beauty of living in the West Coast. And that's great to hear for you guys having breakfast with the Thunderbirds and the Huskies, and that's the thing, Armand Alawalia. You move out to that West Coast, and you can get your full day of sports in and still have 4 or 5 hours left in the day.
Oh, it's great. I mean, even moving just 2 hours, I mean, Monday Night Football goes a little late, and when you have school the next morning early, it's tough to get up. So definitely an advantage on the West Coast for sure.
So far, so good for UBC, but you got to think, I was saying to Cooper, I mean, really the only difference, well, not the only difference besides from the hot shooting, has been the fact that UBC had that 6-point trip with the 4 technical foul shots and the dunk.
Yeah, I'm not sure what that was about, though.
Yeah.
What was that for?
I think Barrett was a little frustrated and got teed up, and then Barry Rolick got on the refs, and they fouled him, or they gave him the tee as well. But we were talking last night. I mean, based on what I've heard from we're courtside here, and based on what I've heard some of these coaches say to officials, I was surprised to see a technical foul, because Barry Rolick certainly appeared like a pretty calm guy to me. And
one guy who's not been teed up, Scott Morrison from Lakehead, he's quite a chirper. He likes to talk.
Yeah. My favorite chirper has been Kevin Hansen of UBC. He just nonstop with the officials. And so I'm Barry Rolick's probably, him and Coach Hansen are probably going to have a good laugh after the game, that of the two coaches, it's Rolick who gets the tee.
Exactly, yeah.
But that's really kind of been the difference. You know, that, I mean, it was really tight, and then that really kind of swung momentum towards UBC's favor.
It did. And as you can see now, the score is 64-46. So UBC starting to pull away now. I mean, they are loaded with talent. I can see why they're the number one seed. But unfortunately, they're not playing in the final game, which I'm sure they would love to, as every team does. But definitely a lot of athleticism. It's almost like an NBA Phoenix Suns game.
Right.
No real defense going on.
Right.
A lot of just fast pace, fast break, tempo going on.
Well, Kamar Burke for UBC, we've been talking throughout the broadcast, number 15. Wouldn't mind having a player like that running around the AUS, would you? He's a pretty special talent.
That would be fun to watch, as long as he's playing for Dalhousie. definitely a lot of talent. And I was looking at the roster. there's a lot of fourth-year and fifth-year guys, which definitely make a difference down the stretch. I mean, how they're going to manage in the next few years, but I think they've got a couple of redshirt guys. One guy from Winnipeg, Chad Pastamas or whatever. It's probably brutal pronunciation of his last name. But tore apart records that Todd McCulloch, who's playing the NBA, set in Winnipeg years ago. Mm-hmm. And just absolute dominating player. And he's a redshirt. So what does that say about that program over there?
And they got this Nixon kid who's just kind of playing his way in. He's a first-year player. And Jazz Gill as well.
Definitely a lot of talent. I mean, they have a good program going over there at UBC, and they're going to be around for quite a while.
Getting over to Saskatchewan, Jamal Barrett. UBC is really kind of pushing him around, aren't they? He's having a tough day.
Yeah, he is. He is. They finally found the cure. His kryptonite has been found. The first game, 27 points against a good Dow defense, and then 28 points last night in the loss, but still, just an amazing player. But next year, they're going to be back again, except for their backcourt will be out without the Shabbat.
And Nerdahl.
Yeah. Mm. But again, Michael Leifer is so physical, so athletic, unreal.
I was going to say, he is a really a special player, and he'll come back for his fifth year. Against Dow, I really thought he was a difference. I mean, Barrett obviously played a great game, but I thought that it seemed like Joe Scow and Sandy Veit, two post players we know very well from watching all year, it just seemed like they had a really difficult time matching up with Michael Leifers.
They did. And the one thing that definitely swung in Saskatchewan's favor was the way that they rebounded in the second half, and Michael Leifers was a huge part of that. I think he had 17 rebounds, in the game prior or the first game. So definitely a huge rebounder, and he uses his athleticism to his advantage, which works for him. So,
well, in our first game, Lakehead against Dalhousie, Lakehead with a nice little win. And again, that came down to pretty much one play as well, that inbounds play where Julius Grant couldn't get it inbounded. Do you think that was more of a breakdown on Dow's part or just a lot of grit by Lakehead?
Well, I don't know. They say more than a coincidence. And
right.
Saskatchewan definitely wore down Dow in the fourth quarter. Dow just doesn't seem to be a fourth quarter team in this tournament. Mm. But that was just 80 seconds of just complete crumble right there. And you could see it kind of slowly as they had a 76-72 lead. And then it just completely swung the other way. So
two programs right there. We were saying in our post-game analysis that Lakehead and Dow, even with some graduation of some fifth-year seniors, you got to expect they would be right back in the mix next year.
They could be back next year for sure. The OUA is very competitive, and Lakehead kind of, even though they won it, but they had a 17-5 record, and there was a couple teams that were just right behind them. So you've got Windsor as well, that's kind of close to them. So it'll be interesting to see how it all shakes down next year. But more than likely, Carleton will be back. That's a program that UBC Saskatchewan will have be back. So might be a couple of the same teams next year.
Well, let's get your call here. Carleton versus Trinity Western in the national championship. Who are you taking?
I like Trinity Western. When I first looked at the brackets and looked at the teams, I said, you know what? Trinity Western has a favorable matchup on the road to the final. I think they can do it. I think they've got those two guards, Kyle Costin, and the height definitely makes a huge difference.
Costin is a special talent. Throughout the weekend, people around the Metro Center start talking about people, and a lot of people talking about Costin and the way he can get up.
He can jump the lights out. That's for sure. Almost like DeMar DeRozan.
I tell you what, Carleton, too, I saw them against Concordia, and I wasn't impressed with their performance against Concordia. Nearly lost to Concordia, but last night, I get it now. Carleton, a strong, strong basketball team. And
Tyson Hintz,
deserving
was
player.
Was the big point last year.
Well, my friend, we're about to start here. Yeah. Outstanding analysis all weekend long.
As always.
Arman Aluwalia of the Dalhousie Gazette. You can follow him on Twitter at TheRealBrindian. The Real, BRINDIAN, on Twitter. And you can check out his website, oneinthestands.wordpress.com. Thanks, Cooper. A regular contributor to sportsstream.ca as well. So thanks very much, Armand, for all that stuff. Cooper, you're going to get your first taste of carrying a broadcast by yourself. I got to check out for about a minute. I'll be
back. Sounds good. We're always on the fly here at SSN Canada, so that's exciting. As checking back into this game here. Again, the Huskies have 46 points and UBC has 64 points. Now we got Huskies ball as they try and chip into this UBC lead that has just been dominated by a combination of you, Burke, and a great transition. So again, Chabot throws it up, and it's good for two. And again, he works around the UBC defenders and manages to find the hole. And it was a no easy feat. There was a couple big guys there in the key. Again, Yu is just playing a stellar game here for UBC. Throws it up again, and he's been a huge offensive presence here for UBC in this game. Speaking of huge presences, Brundell has just been stellar for the Huskies. He's just getting in. Just trying to push the ball. You can see he's putting a lot of effort in to get back in this game and make this happen. And so good passing there. And we've got Chabot on the line again from the charity stripe. We'll see what he can do. So again, chip away at this lead. We've got 48-67 for UBC. Huskies are a talented team. Again, defending champions are quite capable to get back in this game. It's going to take a little bit more of their shots falling. Again, they just haven't had the stellar shooting game that UBC has been running with for the start of this game. And they're also going to have to be able to stop UBC in transition, which has just been hurting them really terribly so far. And the ball's going to be out of bounds. It's going to be Huskies ball. Leifer's inbounding the ball to a double-team Barrett, who's looking for some support from his teammates there.
Keep it going, bud.
Oh, I was just going to say Bill McLean's rejoining us here. All right, Leifer's. Oh, basket is no good. That foul looks like it's on the ground. I'll let you take over here for Bill.
Thank you very much. Well, it didn't miss too much. One minute and a nice little... We got 3 points exchanged by both teams, 67-50 here. Saskatchewan, I think Saskatchewan's going to make a run, Cooper. I think that UBC is going to cool off here at some point.
Well, just I don't know what their percentage was, but I don't think it's reasonable to expect any team to keep up the rate that they were going at.
Great backdoor cut. Chabot for two. Chabot. So there we go.
He's been a huge factor in this, sort of starting to chip away here. He's really pushing it for his team, and that was a great finish.
So Alex Murphy. Swung around there to Nathan Yu. Burkle screen on Nerdahl. And Yu into the lane, and Nerdahl just kind of had to hang in there and ends up getting the foul.
It was a great effort there on Nerdahl's part to get through that screen. That was a tough screen. You could really see he was doing everything he could to stay with Yu. Again, no easy feat to guard. Pardon me, to guard Yu at this point. Yu's been shooting the lights out. He's been setting up things in transition. He's just been doing it all. So no easy task.
Big rebound by Leafers, and as mentioned, Saskatchewan starting to look a little bit more confident here. Barrett, he had a tough first half, trying to get it going here. In the second, he's got two.
He's just getting warmed up, I think.
67-54, so Barrett might have iced down an elbow or his eye
or his eye.
Wherever else he got hit in that half. And now starting to feel it. Malish going to work for UBC. Nicely done.
So many options offensively for UBC.
A long pass for Chabot, puts on the brakes and goes over the top of Mayotte. So here we go.
Chabot has been huge again. Snuck down there and got that long pass in transition and just pulled what UBC's been doing to the Huskies right back on them.
Murphy. And you getting tough guarding again by Nerdahl. And a kick out and a wide open three for Mayotte. Heavy and big rebound by Burke. Wide open as Mayotte takes it himself for two. And 15 points to lead.
That's a bit of a heartbreaker there when you would let that rebound go. Defensive rebounding so huge for the Huskies at this point. You can't let a great team like UBC or any team for that matter just get those easy buckets as a result of offensive boards.
So here we go, friends. 71-56, 7:20 left, and what a great pass that was by Burke. You see it on your screen now. And while that was going on, Alex Murphy for three.
Holy Dinah. He's just decided, no, it's all me right here.
74-56, and the senior, Jamal Barrett here, struggling. And they're going to call that was a weird play. I don't know if it took the referee by surprise or something as well, but it took a while for him to call it.
Yeah, I'm confused by that play as well. So Barrett, I think, is also confused by that play, but he's going to go on and get his defense on. And the Huskies are still really working hard in this game that just hasn't been going their way so far.
That is you working on leafers. Burke passes up on the little foul line jumper in order to get the turnaround. And I think the coaches might tell him to just kind of maybe pop that foul line jumper as opposed to, I don't know.
The dipsy do. Yeah, that was such a tough shot. Again, fading away is hard. No, it's hard to get off well, but he was fading away from quite far away, and it's a tough shot.
18 points the difference. Saskatchewan back to work here. It is Shabbat. Passes up on the three, gets into the lane, and runs into Mayotte. No foul on the play, and heads up here. Nathan Yu in transition and takes it himself for two.
Holy transition, Batman. UBC is like writing the textbook on how to play transition basketball today.
Well, here they got McKen Cooper. Four white shirts across half court, led by Malish. Murphy had a 10-footer, but passed up. And now UBC will set something up here in the half court.
I think UBC might still be in this game pretty well, even if they only had their transition points to their credit. It's just unbelievable how well they've been running transition, and Huskies definitely need to be able to adjust to that game plan and put a stop to it. A huge part of that is just, you know, ball pressure. Just if someone gets a rebound, at least put ball pressure on so they can't. It's such a hard pass to make right down the court, but at least make it that much harder and then hope that you've got a big guy or some other guard running back to get the other guy.
Nathan Yu comes up short on that three. And on Mayotte. Back out to Murphy on the weak side. Rebound and confusion with Murphy and Mayotte. And Graham Bath checking back in here. Malish will check out.
Malish hasn't, you know, Burke's been a huge storyline out of the bigs here for UBC, but Malish has definitely got his own and got a few key points and some great rebounds so far this game.
That is Duncan Jones. He had a couple big three-pointers in the first half. Gets into the lane. And there's a wide-open look for Brent Baker. Heavy and brought down at the foul line by Murphy. He runs into Burke and now finally collects. Picked up there by Jones. And Mayotte with a wide-open look for three. Heavy is Mayotte. And brought down on the weak side by Nathan Yu.
Husky's just looking a little all over the map right here. They've just got to start rebounding and doing the little things right so they can get back in this.
Nathan Yu gets past Baker and cleared by Unsworth. He would have had the rebound, but instead was trying to kind of get it off the rim. But it was coming off. And now UBC with another chance. Bath could not get it over Unsworth.
This game is getting pretty physical down low. You can see there's a lot of pushing and shoving, and it's just really tough to get post shots off for either team right now.
76-56, 20 points the lead for UBC. 5 minutes left in the third quarter, and Duncan Jones up top. Nicely done, Jamal Barrett over the top of you.
We just got a small taste there of what Barrett can do. We don't think we've seen the full. We haven't seen full-on Barrett today. You know, it's just again he's got hammered early on in the first half, and he's just trying to get back. And you get the sense he's not in the full swing of his game. Not to slight him in the least. It's but definitely a talented player.
Doug Plum back out here now for UBC. That is Baker over there on you. Bath sets the screen and rolls, but knocked away by Unsworth, and now you got Unsworth on you. So you just blows right past Unsworth, gets into the lane, and one with continuation for you. So great recognition by the senior. Notice Unsworth on him, and just went right to the basket.
Yeah, in the same way that a big man is going to look to use his size, posting up someone small down low, you definitely pulled the reverse a little, David and Goliath on there, and just used his quickness against Unsworth to get to the basket and draw the foul.
So you with the chance to finish off an and one. He's got it to go. And big time separation now for UBC. 21 points.
And Carl Yu is a huge part of that storyline for UBC. He's just done a lot of little things. Nathan Yu. He's just done so many good things for his team. Setting up transition, making all his shots. Just been an outstanding player so far.
Little handoff here. Brudel spins his way down in the lane. It gets blocked by Baines. So that's a great matchup down there. A couple of long-rangey guys.
That's a whole lot of arm down there for sure. And well done by Baines to get a hand on it.
So Baines on the floor for UBC. Bath, Yu, Plum, and Murphy. And that is Leifers. Gets into the lane and kicks out for Barrett from the baseline. And nice easy points there for Leifers off that miss.
We'll call that one a pass.
That's the second time Leifers has had an easy basket on a mistake by one of the guards. So.
For sure. To his credit, he was right down there in position, and there wasn't a UBC guy to be found. No one was boxing him out, and he got to the right place.
And now a turnover for UBC, and Saskatchewan can start to chip away here. 19 points the deficit.
They're definitely going to have to pick up the pace, though, if they're looking to chip away, because it's not like you can easily go on a run against this team.
Oh, well, Barrett does a good job. Gets right into the body there at Bath, and he's going to get a foul. I know as a post player, Cooper, that's something that probably drove you crazy. Like a small guard who just kind of gets their body right into you on that drive.
And you're so used to playing against bigger guys or bigger women and having them spin a certain way, and the way guards move and can use their quickness and agility is a whole different ballgame. It's something that you're not always used to.
Well, tigerswebcast@gmail.com is your email. Hello out there to Vic and Elsie Schmidt. And show Ron Glover. Thanks for emails. Nearly a 5 second on UBC, but Bath's got it in here to you. Picked up by Nerdall is Nathan Yu and Alex Murphy, the senior. Great matchup there with Barrett up top to Bath. And a little partner posts high-low down here with Baines, and he comes up short on the turnaround. And that is to Saskatchewan.
Nice little bit of pressure. We're seeing Saskatchewan starting to put some pressure on UBC, and it's definitely a tactic they're going to have to use if they're going to cut down this lead. They're going to have to look for a couple quick turnovers and not have UBC sort of walk down the court and run their set offense too easily.
Double screen there for Barrett, and that sets up Nerdahl. Gets a little push off on you and turns it over, or loses it out of bounds. It'll stay with Saskatchewan. Mm-hmm. 10 seconds on the shot clock. And that'll be Barrett to inbounds.
Interesting to see what the Huskies are going to run and who they're going to set up for the shot here.
Jones is going to get a screen from Brudel. Baines pops out on that, and Jones goes over the top of Baines but comes up just short. And now here comes you with the rebound, and now in transition gets into the body of Nerdahl. Kicks it out for Murphy for three. Comes up short. He hasn't missed much, but comes up short on that one. Mm-hmm. In the full court now, it is Barrett. Speedy and quick, and the little floater heavy. And great job by Leafers over the top of Baines, and then gets blocked by Baines. So great big man matchup there.
Baines is two blocks, and that's huge. Just sort of sending a message to the Huskies.
Beautiful looking pass. Alex Murphy and Graham Bath with the easy finish. What a beautiful pass that was by Murphy. Man, oh, man. And now Barrett, not to be undone, with a nice dish and a left-handed finish for Leafers. So we're seeing point guards and big men and beautiful basketball
working together in perfect harmony. It's definitely this great, great highlight reels left, right, and center. We just saw that great pass by Barrett. And Leafers, you know, again, putting himself in great position to sort of be able to get that pass. And it's so tough to pass through the paint, you know, against good teams. And both teams managed to do it here.
81-65, 16 points to deficit, and 2:47 left. Murphy very nicely done. Gets through Brudel. And then sets up Malish, and he is going to get a foul down there on Nerdahl.
Nice little spin move by Alex Murphy to get through that trap there. He just sort of rolled off of it. It was a great example of the experience, I think, that UBC brings. We're not going to get flustered against a younger team. Getting in a big game, getting trapped in the court, half court like that, throws people off. And, you know, Alex Murphy's seen it all before, and it wasn't a problem.
Well, the fifth-year senior from Richmond, B.C., and he's having a good time out here. It's his last game of his career. That was a gorgeous pass to Graham Bath. I don't think the camera picked it up, but we saw it right at midcourt here. It looked away his defender and just fired a bullet.
Yep. To all the kids watching out there, this is the kind of passing you want to be able to do there. So work on your passing.
And you post kids, or you post players, love that, don't you, Cooper, when you run down the floor and get an easy basket? That'll get you playing defense on the other end.
For sure. We do love that very much. And we're looking a little dog pile on the floor there again. Poor Barrett is having people fall on him, all sorts of stuff. He's really taken a hit. You can see his teammate is sort of falling down. He's trying to protect himself and his teammate there. It's just been a physical game in every possible way, just with other teammates and with the hardwood for this guy. And he's been a soldier. Keeps going on.
It'd be one of those things, if we had the technology, it'd be great to get our production crew. Let's say if we had, you know, they put the highlight packages together on the big
Barrett,
broadcast
Barrett
to show all the highlights of Barrett getting beat up today. The eye poke, the fall down, you know, it's just been unbelievable.
And he's playing through it. So it's not the Barrett and the finesse that we're used to seeing. We're used to seeing him being able to take his team almost on his shoulders at sometimes and really lead the charge. And he's doing his best, and he's looking to his teammates to also sort of help with the scoring against this great UBC team.
82-66, and hoping that maybe Saskatchewan can make a run here. Otherwise, even if they can't, it has been a very fun basketball game to watch.
For sure.
Pass going to go down here to Malish. Malish going to work. And very nicely done by Malish. Cleared a lot of space down there.
Mm-hmm. Just he just muscled himself right against Burns there and got to the basket.
That is Burns up top. Gets it knocked away by Mayotte, and Murphy has a loose ball, and now 18 points lead for UBC, looking for more. Tough pass, great play by Mayotte. Reversal, Malish, Murphy for three, and UBC is just rolling right now. These are the number one seeded Thunderbirds, and they are looking all of that.
Yep. It's almost like they're sending a message to everyone, like, watch out for us. You know, this is really setting the tone here, and just playing unhurried, great basketball today.
87-66, and the Huskies really scrambling now. They are looking a little bit out of sorts, while UBC is just looking very comfortable.
It's true. Although that was a great pass right there by Barrett. He was finding Burns under the basket, and Barrett's been setting up some good assists and some good plays here for his team.
This is Burns. Tough little runner there for the youngster. Mm-hmm. And Unsworth could not get that one off in time.
It's just a tough. UBC is not giving anything easy to the Huskies here. You're not gonna get a little open layup. There's gonna be someone kind of waiting to put a little bit of pressure on you at all times. So
you know what, Cooper? We got a great email here from Brian Digby, and we've been having so much fun watching Alex Murphy and Burke and these other guys. Malish hit shots. Just noticing now as Bath just does a workmanlike effort there to get a foul. Mm-hmm. Brian Digby, thanks very much. No Josh White on the floor today for
right.
UBC and. I am not sure. I can't see down there far enough to see if he's in street clothes or uniform. But yeah, no Josh White today.
That's interesting. Again, UBC's been playing so well and then just have such a lot of talent that we've been missing out on that storyline. But it'll be interesting to find out why that is and what would be the cause for that.
Well, no Josh White, no problem so far. 22 points to the lead for UBC and. If you're just joining us, you've missed out on some beautiful passing basketball.
Mm-hmm. You know, again, a testament to the depth of this team that Josh White, just such a huge contributor, so much, you know, the 5 years of experience sets up this team so well and has just got a lot of tough games under his belt. And to not be out there and to still have his team performing as well is a testament to the depth and experience of this UBC team.
Her name is Emma Cooper. My name is Bill McLean, and you are on SSNCanada.ca and TigersWebcast@gmail.com is our email. Wrapping up our weekend coverage here, and we've had a blast. And thank you so much for being with us throughout the weekend.
It has been fun. It's been a great weekend, and this has been a great game, and it continues to be. We've just got a minute left in this third quarter here, but looking forward to the final game as well. Should be exciting. So,
Trinity Western and Carleton. Carleton has won 6 of the last 8 national championships. And look at that. Nice 3-shot, 3-ball there by Nurdle.
That was textbook. That was great form.
20 points, though, in confusion for UBC. The turnover. So now Saskatchewan can start to claw away at this thing towards the end of the third quarter here.
Yeah, they've got to use every opportunity they can. And we talk about in this game, Huskies have been getting points and UBC's been coming right back and getting a point or 2 points in less than 10 seconds. So they've also got to be able to stop this tough team defensively.
Beautiful backdoor pass by Unsworth to Barrett and a finish.
I'm waiting for the replay on that one.
Yeah.
We talk about physics and defying gravity. I think Barrett just did that right there.
Look at that beautiful pass and
nice
great
pass.
Adjustment by Barrett.
How on earth did he even... He didn't even use the backboard on that, did he? That's amazing. The pass was a little bit behind him, too, and to be able to have the body coordination, to pick up the pass from behind you, channel your momentum in the way that you want to go, and then, you know, flip your body around in the air is an amazing, amazing example of the athleticism and grit that this guy brings to this Huskies team.
And, of course, it wouldn't be a day for Barrett unless he took a little bit of contact as well, hit the floor
that's pretty hard.
So.
Yeah, exactly.
And more confusion for UBC. And, friends, this may be a storyline. This is the last minute of play here in the third quarter. And UBC is really giving Saskatchewan a chance to get back into this.
Mm-hmm. They're playing tough, and they're not giving up by any means.
And with a three-pointer here by Barrett, it's a 15-14 point game.
And this is the Barrett that people are used to seeing. The Saskatchewan fans are ringing some cowbells, and this is the kind of play that they've come to love from this guy.
So now a very working deficit for the Huskies. They can make get a chance to get back in this one. One more stop and a score, and they'd be in business. Grant Bath misses. Duncan Jones controls. 10 seconds on the quarter clock here. And it is Barrett. Jones for three, short. So that would have been huge.
That would have been huge for sure. Again, great effort. You got to love the hustle that these Huskies are coming back, and they've got to take that momentum and that energy that we just saw late in that third and get back into it again. You know, you always want to be able to have that shot hit, but no matter, they've just got to shrug it off and move on. They're well equipped to come back and get into this game, and it's just 89 UBC, 75 for the Huskies. So the whole quarter left of 10 minutes of play, they're totally able to get back into it.
Well, one of our great great emailers this weekend, Mr. Watkins, out there in Los Angeles, the father of Tristan Smith, of course, Tristan, the outstanding point guard for Trinity Western, and a big shout out to all the Canadian West teams from Mr. Watkins and.
Battling the time difference, battling a long flight, and coming out and dominating out here in the East Coast.
10:30 there in Los Angeles, so hello out there to you guys in Cooper. Coach Watkins is right. We still have a game to play, and maybe Carleton might spoil the party, but really the talk around Halifax has been these Canada West teams. They're just the speed of the guards and the size of the posts. The hype is definitely warranted.
The hype is more than warranted, and I think we're seeing some teams here that have just played so well together as well. You've got teams where you can have talented individuals that don't. They're maybe looking to break down one-on-one all the time and play their own game. And the teams that we're seeing floating to the top here in terms of talent have just a full roster of stacked talent, and they're playing together really well. They're playing disciplined basketball, and they're playing gritty defense as well. And it's been a pleasure to watch a lot of these teams bring it. And for some of the AUS teams, again, it's been a tough conference in the AUS, and no easy feat to come on top and get to the nationals here for Acadia and for Dalhousie. But they do have to take a lot away from being able to get up some big against some big teams like UBC, get those experience points, and know that this is the kind of level of basketball that you're going to have to bring in order to win a championship.
Great set play here for UBC, but just torn away from Brudel by Murphy. That was a nice little set play, and Brudel just took it away from Murphy, and now Duncan Jones, looking resilient down there, has two, and it's a 12-point game.
Jones and Brudel are both huge factors in this Huskies comeback, and the play that they're bringing to this game has been lots of energy and lots of hustle.
And Brudel nearly had that one. 12 points of deficit, a 9-point run for the Huskies. You misses. Brudel has it. Here comes Saskatchewan in transition, led by Barrett for three. Got it. 9 points, the game difference.
You gotta love this. Barrett is he's shrugged off all the injuries, and he's getting right back into this.
And my fault, friends, that is a two long two. So
that's
a two given that. So 10 points the difference right now.
We'll take it. Barrett's been playing well, and he's just ramping up, and his game has gotten better and better as this game has gone on. UBC's got to be a bit worried right now.
An 11-point run for the Huskies. Malice trying to answer. See? That's why I knew. I just lost my headset. My cord. You've been making fun of me, but it's been an issue for
me. It's been an issue, yeah.
There we go.
Here we got the highlight reel here.
Of me losing my headset?
No, not of you losing the headset. Of the full contact game that's going on right here. And we got Murphy at the line here, and he's going to take his time and knock down the first one.
Murphy has won, and now a 90-79 for UBC. TigersWebcast@gmail.com. One more chance to check in with us before we turn it over to our friends at TSN2. 91-79?
Yep. That's the score. And pretty effort here. The Huskies, you got to appreciate this comeback. No one is quitting on this team. And Barrett being able to sort of light the spark. And, Brundell and Jones, Burns also responding in kind. It's just been a pleasure to watch.
Skip pass over there for Jones from Barrett. And look at the block by Kamar Burke. We haven't seen him in a bit. And he welcomes himself back with a thud.
We just saw him there for sure. It seems when Burke does something, he does it with a lot of authority, and that block
was
a great example.
Announces his presence with authority. I couldn't get my head to think of it quick enough. A big block.
It was
big.
Damn,
this lack of intelligence.
I like that. It was a big thud. I we could hear the thud through our headsets, so I think that was a fair thing to say completely.
Well, Coach Hansen having words for his fifth-year senior, Alex Murphy. And they're trying to stem the tide here. Saskatchewan got it down to 10 on an 11-point run, but now UBC with Doug Plum at the line. Can get it back up. Oh, there's one miss. They can get it back up to 13 now.
And action at the charity stripe has been an issue for teams. You know, we haven't been able to take anything for granted from the foul line. Plum just missed two there, and there's been other teams where foul shooting has come down to it, and they've lost and won games based on foul shooting.
Brudel just gets the rebound, takes it all the way down himself, and gets a foul on UBC. So nicely done by Brudel.
Brudel is playing huge this game, taking a lot of initiative, really stepping up when this Huskies team was struggling, and is playing quite well now that Barrett's getting more of his mojo back, and they're playing quite as a good team.
Brudel's got the first one down. That foul on Doug Plum. He has three now, so fouls starting to become a storyline. And Brudel missed the next one and can't get his own rebound. And now here comes UBC in transition. Plum nearly travels. And they'll settle things down.
And Huskies more focused on that transition. They know that UBC's been getting easy points, and they're not prepared to give up any more of those.
Nice looking jump shot here. Alex Murphy for two.
Yeah, this guy just won't go away. Alex Murphy, been playing huge all game, continues to do so.
13 points, great pass. Barrett and Brudel with the finish.
These guys seem to have a psychic connection right now. Brudel was all hands, ready to catch that, and it was a great feed by Barrett.
And Doug Plum, Plum wants to settle things down, and Coach Hansen telling him, no, keep pushing it. And now Plum down to Malish. Nice looking pass. Kamar Burke for two.
Kamar Burke always assertive, making his presence be felt down low.
Baker on the far side there for Saskatchewan, down to Brudel. 7:36 left, 13 points to lead. Spinning Brudel over the top of Malish.
I thought that one was in, Bill.
Yeah, Leafers couldn't get it to follow. And now Burke. And not one of Burke's better passes of the weekend, but we've seen him make some doozies. But that one, not one of them.
Pretty good for a big man in transition, but yeah. Credit to Barrett also. Barrett's been playing tons of minutes, and he was also getting in there and putting a little bit of ball pressure on. And that's the kind of hustle that you love to see for players, especially players playing so many minutes, but being able to just go and sort of jab and step back and put a little ball pressure and fake and be cagey like that. And in some cases, it causes turnovers, and it's well worth the effort.
So set your scoreboard, 7:25 left in the fourth quarter, and 95-82 for UBC. The Huskies won. This kid is nearly killing me with frisbees here.
Yeah, we've got some halftime entertainment.
Let's get some.
Let's throw three freebies out, and they look a little dangerous.
Let's get a little more height on those frisbees, please. I really don't need that much of a.
Blackberry decapitates people with the frisbees.
The 95-82 again. The score is 7:25 left, and the Huskies went on a nice little 11-0 run there at the start or at the end of the third quarter, but UBC with a nice little response.
This is a back-and-forth game, and there's no easy win against these top teams. We talk about these guys both being easily contenders, and this could easily have been the gold medal game. It's just such a tough weekend all around, and it's fallen that this is the bronze medal game. But we're seeing a real effort here from both teams, particularly the Huskies, as they're trying to get back into this. We've seen a lot of finesse and a lot of amazing plays by UBC, but the real grit here by the Huskies to get back in this and contest for this bronze medal.
Well, Jamal Barrett's going to waste as much time as possible. Murphy will let him pick it up. And now here come the Huskies. Fresh shot clock for Saskatchewan, 20 seconds. And that is Barrett. Adjusts on Malish, comes up short, and Malish clears, and he's got Murphy on the run. Murphy into the lane, over the top of Baker. Big follow by Burke, but he misses. And Plum can't control the rebound, but now Murphy spinning on the baseline over the top of Baker again, but short again, and now here comes Leafers.
This game is high tempo, and it got a little sloppy there, but both teams are totally pushing it late into this fourth.
And Coach Hansen wants a three-second call on Leafers just before the touch, but none forthcoming, but no luck for Leafers, and now in transition with Malish. Great pass down to Malish for Murphy, and an easy two for Malish.
The Huskies got a little confused there, and they thought that maybe the set offense was going to get run, but UBC capitalized.
Barrett into the lane. Heavy on the finger roll and brought down by Burke, and I think we might be starting to see the end here.
We're not seeing a lot of set offense either. This is all transition all the time right now.
Plum loses it, gets it back, and I tell you, Saskatchewan, taking the Huskies a long time to get down the floor on defense right now.
It is, and it's hurt them. It's hurt them a lot, and it's a huge part of the UBC dominance so far in this game.
Nathan Yu, a tough runner in the lane. You got to think UBC could get an easier shot than that.
The game's getting a little sloppy here. It's getting all over the place as the Huskies are desperately trying to get back into this, and UBC has been also running pretty hard in transition themselves.
Baker. Nurdle. Now back to Baker, the third-year player from Saskatoon, down to Barrett, the fifth-year senior from California, sets up leafers, and we got a foul here on UBC.
And you gotta love Barrett. He was posting up down there. I mean, how tall is this guy? Lots of heart and effort coming from Barrett, who refuses to give up.
Well, that foul on UBC. That is Nathan Yu, his third, so he'll take a seat. Man, the Carleton game last night, Carleton and Saskatchewan, what a foul fest that was. Holy cow, great basketball game, but it was just foul fest. Ninth foul fest 2011. Oh, my Lord.
Maybe not what people come out to see.
No. Guys were fouling out late in the third quarter.
Yeah, that's always been. It's been a few of those sort of things happening in this tournament overall. It's been pretty tough.
Nice strip play down there by Nerdahl on Malish, but Malish gets it back, and an easy little finish there over the top of Brudel.
Huskies are going to have to be able to stop this tough UBC team if they're hoping to claw back in. Time is ticking down, and again, 99-83 is getting to be a bit of a deficit.
Nicely done here by Mayotte to get a hand on that pass, and coming his way back in transition, Murphy picks up his dribble, and now he'll get it back from Malish and set up a play here for the Thunderbirds. 16 seconds on the shot clock for UBC. That is Leafers getting it on Murphy, and now that's the matchup. Nice little post entry. Plum picks up the bouncing ball, and Murphy for three. He's got it, Alex Murphy. And back up to a 19-point lead now.
Murphy's feeling great about that shot. He was calling, Doug, get me the ball. And again, his teammate caught him wide open, and he made it.
So 102-83. With 4:50 left, Nerdahl needs to get this for Saskatchewan. He's got it. Back to 16 points.
Nerdahl's been another guy who's just been stepping in and stepping up for this Huskies team, contributing when he has to.
102-86, and Murphy calls a set play here for the Thunderbirds. Burke will set a screen on Barrett. Leafers pops out on that, and there's matched up again with Murphy and Malish. Heavy on that wide open three and brought down. Oh, confusion for the Huskies, and it's going to go out of bounds. And Nerdahl, that might just about do it. Nerdahl not happy with himself.
No, that's a tough thing to have happen again. Nerdahl's been making an excellent effort for this Huskies team overall. A few huge shots for him, lots of effort. But it's just that's an untimely turnover. They definitely needed to be able to run their stuff and get another quick three in order to have a hope here.
Unsworth out here now. Duncan Jones, that is Brudel coming around that screen, popping out, and Murphy into the lane, finds Burke, and now a wide open look for Malish, passes on it, and now the shot clock getting down here, 7 seconds for UBC, that is Plum on Jones, gets a screen by Burke, tries to split Brudel, ball on the floor, Murphy picks it up, and a long three just misses, and there's Big Unsworth clearing for Saskatchewan. Brudel. They got Unsworth. He wants it bad, but they didn't give it to him down on the block. And now they'll set up a shot.
Huskies probably do need to look for a three here.
That is Shabbat. Malish. And Duncan Jones for three. There it is, Emma Cooper, but he came up heavy. Chris Unsworth will clean it up for two. 102-88. 14 points to deficit. And a block by Jones, but on the body was the foul on Murphy.
I'm not even sure how UBC is transitioning so quickly. Like, by the time the other team has scored and you're just sort of refocusing enough time to turn your head down to look the other way down the court, someone's already getting fouled at the other end, and it's amazing. They must practice just quickly inbounding the ball because they're so quick and so precise with how they're using their transition so effectively.
Alex Murphy with another foul shot. Again, one of the stat lines that really impressed me reading in preparation was 21 for 22 foul shots in the Can West final.
Wow.
That's dialed in.
That is dialed in. And to be getting to the line that many times is amazing as well.
104-88, 16 points to lead, 3:12 left in the fourth quarter. Barrett over the top of Murphy. Comes up short and brought down by big Kamar Burke. And here comes the big man in transition. Behind the back dribble. The full array of skills with a nice pass now for you. And an easy little 10-footer there for Nathan.
great setup by Burke. It was awesome to have a big guy that can dribble down the court like that.
Duncan Jones right back here for the Huskies. Well done by Duncan. 16 points as we go back and forth, and the Thunderbirds starting to put a wrap on this one.
Mm-hmm. You got to think that if the Huskies are going to have a hope, they're going to have to do some full court pressing in order to get some easy turnovers.
Friends, please join me on my live blog, sportsstream.ca, for the live blog of the gold medal game. I'll be doing my best there. I'm getting the hang of it as the weekend goes on. Duncan Jones for three from the baseline. A little bit heavy. He's been a little bit off today. And now Nathan Yu in the transition takes it himself for two over the top of Barrett. And that'll do it. 18 points the lead with 2 minutes left.
Barrett's not giving up, though. He's going full speed, and he's making those passes still. Just crisp passes into the post.
Leafers heavy on that putback and cleared by Malish, and the UBC fans starting to feel it.
Yeah, the game is winding down here. Murphy's looking pretty relaxed, and they're just going to have some fun with it in the last minute here of play.
Well, the youngster Tommy Nixon from Vancouver will check in for UBC. 6 seconds on the shot clock. Handoff play for you. Maybe his last three of the season for Nathan Yu. That might be the last of his career.
Well, you never know. The way he's been shooting, he could easily get another one.
The fourth-year senior, we'll see if he comes back for next year. Graham Bath going to check in as well.
You got to expect that some of these fourth years are going to want to be coming back with a team like this. You don't get an opportunity to play on a really high functioning team like this. Every time it's a special position to be in. So you got to imagine a lot of these guys are going to want to be coming back.
Well, here's one of them, Big Kamar Burke, the fourth year senior from Mississauga. We'll see if he's back next year. I'm sure Thunderbirds fans hope he is. Brent Malish, well done, young man. He will check out of his final game. The fifth year senior.
We got a standing applause or a standing ovation here from the Thunderbirds, and also from looking like some Halifax folks here acknowledging their hard work over the years.
So my live blog coming up on sportstream.ca. We had no video on that, but I do my best to keep the play-by-play going. I'll have interviews on there and polls.
All sorts of good stuff.
Yeah, whenever a player asks me for a sub, I'll let you know. That's been my favorite thing about the weekend. Players asking me for subs.
That's right. We look like we're the scorekeepers here.
Leafers for two. Coach is asking me for timeouts. Sorry, coach, I can't do that.
Yeah. This is a Huskies team that is still pushing hard right to the end. Particularly Barrett. We're talking about the effort on this guy. He's diving on the floor in the dying minutes of the game, and it's a great hustle.
107 left, and turnover now. In transition, Duncan Jones, he's going to get a foul here on this play.
Great speed on Duncan Jones. He's a pretty tall guy to have the kind of wheels that he's got. He got down the court in a hurry there. Nice pass, and you can see him going up and just sort of throwing it up there, so he's going to go to the line.
Duncan Jones heavy on his first. Jones, a fourth-year player from Calgary, Alberta. Gets the second one to go. 111-95 here in the bronze medal game. The number one seeded Thunderbirds. Not what they had in mind, but they came out today and gave it everything they had.
They did, and they played well, and it looked like they had fun out there. And holy Dinah, did they ever work it in transition.
Alex Murphy nearly had that one to go, so they're going to let the fifth-year senior play out his last game here with 40 seconds left. Actually, maybe not. Jazz Gill will check in here, and I'm assuming that UBC fans are starting to get on their feet.
That's right. These UBC fans are going to have to get up and down a few times because they have a lot of veterans and a lot of talent to celebrate here.
Alex Murphy, he will sit. Hugs for Coach Hansen. He had himself a tournament.
He had himself, indeed he did. He had himself a career here with UBC, and A lot of accolades go to this guy, and a lot of hard work and respect from his teammates.
Nixon, we'll hand off there for Graham Bath. No, I'll fake nobody.
That's when you know you should have shot it, but that's cool.
That vast amount of open space bought his up fake, so he put it on the floor.
That's right.
14 seconds left.
Yep, we're gonna dribble it out here at the Metro Center. And we got the crowd on their feet here, UBC fans, and they're celebrating a hard-fought battle by a team that just incredibly talented.
Saskatchewan Huskies fans on their feet as well. They are giving their team a rousing applause
for sure
for their great season. Two teams who had incredible seasons, UBC, the Can-West champions. The Huskies, the defending champions from last year.
Yep.
And that was a lot of fun, Emma Cooper. They, you talk about a couple very talented, deep, big basketball teams right there. Maybe yep. any other given day, it'd be reversed. It'd be Saskatchewan winning by 16.
Yep.
But it just happened to be that on this day it was UBC.
Yeah, and it's back and forth, and it's always just who can go on the day. And again, we're seeing Josh White sort of hop by here, and so he's clearly injured and wasn't able to play with his team today. Which, as in your fifth year, I'm sure that's a bit devastating is an overstatement, but I'm sure he would have loved to have been out there contributing in that that game that was so much fun for UBC.
So Brian Digby, thanks for that email, and there's your answer. We just saw Josh White. Obviously, not able to play and in street clothes. So, as you just said, Cooper, heartbreak for that senior.
Yes.
But his teammates picked it up for him, and maybe that's why they played so well. One of the reasons they wanted to send Josh White out a winner. And great scene here, the Saskatchewan Huskies fans applauding the players and the Saskatchewan Huskies players applauding their fans.
Mm-hmm. Strong fan contingent out here from Saskatchewan. Their vocal section of supporters, including what I can assume are a lot of parents who are pretty proud of their sons and the hard work that they've put in this season and in seasons past as well. So the Huskies looking a little bit subdued. I'm sure they would have liked to come away with a win, but I don't think they can feel bad about their showing this year. They've put in a good fight, and they lost to a good team, and I don't know that there's any team in the country that can go away feeling completely bad about losing to this UBC team. It's very deep and very talented.
Well, they're going to award the bronze medals here to UBC, and Saskatchewan down here on the far side lining up as well. Alex Murphy announced he'll come out and get his medal. Even in loss yesterday to Trinity Western, I tell you what a game he played. Holy cow. His crossover, a couple times he put a crossover dribble on the Trinity Western point guards. Oh, man.
Blew right
it
by
was,
him.
It was, and the space he would create on his jump shot. Oh, yeah. My Lord. Special talent.
Definitely.
Special basketball team, the number one seeded Thunderbirds, coming up short against a great Trinity Western team. And nothing to hang their heads about.
No, by no means. It's always excitement, and there's nothing you can ever take for granted at this tournament. Trinity Western not favored to necessarily be in that final game, but there they are, and there's no, it's all so many of these teams are so close.
Jazz Gill, first year player from Oliver, BC, he'll be out there next year as one of the main cogs, taking over for this man, Alex Murphy, fifth year senior. Nathan Yu, he'll hopefully be back for his fifth year from Prince George, B.C.
He's a huge player today. Played so well.
Doug Plum, what a physical force he was at the guard spot this weekend.
Mm-hmm.
Pitt Meadows. Baines, so long. Influenced a lot of shots down there on the block.
That's right. Had a couple blocks today as well.
One of the fun players of the tournament, Graham Bath. He had a couple of little incidents with some players and really got under some guys' jerseys. Neat little confrontation with Dirksen yesterday.
Yeah, working hard.
Burke, what a special talent he is.
Definitely.
There's the youngster, Nixon. He'll be one of the main cogs next year.
And for years to come. Mm-hmm. Only in his first year. It's a lot of talent. I never understand how people get so good in high school. Like, what were you doing? Like, how do you... Yeah, it's always amazing.
There's the coach, Kevin Hansen, in his 11th season. Got a lot of great emails by Thunderbirds fans talking about how special the coaching staff is as they announce them now. Randy Knorr, he knows about national championships. He won two with State of X.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, whole team effort to be able to get a team to be this high functioning and to work together this well. An amazing effort on the part of the coaches and on the part of the players to be working together. Think about all the review tape. I mean, you as a coach, you know, Bill, how much tape you got to watch and how much time you have to put in strategically to be able to position your players to put them in a position to win. So truly amazing.
Jamie Wee as well getting his medal, and many people across the country, including Thunderbirds fans, don't know how much longer Jamie Wee will be with this program. They think he is on his way to a head coaching job of his own someday. Mm-hmm. Outstanding young coach. Randy Knorr, a lot of people think he'll be applying for that St. Evex job if Steve Kanchelski ever gives it up.
Coach Gay.
The bronze medal champions, the UBC Thunderbirds, came in and got pushed by Acadia and then pulled away in the fourth quarter over the plucky Axemen. Mm-hmm. And then last night, we're in control, but then in the start of the second half, Trinity Western went on a 12-0 run. And they went back and forth from there, and Trinity Western eventually pulled it out. Great basketball game that was last night.
Mm-hmm. Just battles. It's battles is the word to use. Mm-hmm. It's just there's nothing's come easy for any team here, and you know, even coming in as a top seed playing a lower seeded team, there's not been any easy wins or anything to take for granted. So definitely hard fought battles, and it'll be just exciting to tune in to the gold medal game later this evening.
Great to hear from all you Thunderbirds fans all weekend long. Thanks for emails. Thanks out there to the boys in the Mahoney's Pub there on campus. They plugged us into their big screen there at the pub and had us on during the Acadia game. That was a treat. Thanks very much for you two guys. They sent us a little picture and a lot of fun.
Awesome.
Corey Hedman sent us a lot of great emails. Big Thunderbirds fan and a law student there. Or Cody Hedman, I should say. In UBC, and he also had a connection with you. He went to Malaspina as well.
Oh, wow.
Yep.
Cool.
So great to hear from you guys all across the country this weekend, and I'm glad you enjoyed. And again, you know, this is not the color medal that UBC had gold in their goals. You know, they thought they had the gold.
Yeah.
Or thought they'd be playing for gold, but again, they lost to an incredible basketball team in Trinity Western. And Coach Hansen, after last night, said to his guys, I'll be there tomorrow to coach to win.
Yep.
And so you guys decide if you're going to be there to play to win. And yep. UBC came out, and they were here to play to win.
They sure are. And you can see the different UBC players reflecting on their win right now. And some folks look a little bit pensive right now. Mm. And other people are getting hugs and congratulations from friends and family. So. So it's sort of an emotional moment as you end up the year, and some people know that their careers are over, and a lot of different emotions sort of running high right now for people as they reflect on all the hard work they put in over the years to get to be where they are today. So kind of cool to see.
Well, Emma Cooper, I tell you what, one of the beautiful things about college sports and university basketball is the emotions. And these young men, they achieve such great things. And they do such incredible things on the floor, but always tempered with mistakes as well. You know, they make these mistakes that young men make at times. And that's a beautiful thing about the game. And as we watch right now, is some of these UBC players are really having a hard time keeping their emotions in check. A lot of heavy hearts out here for this UBC team who, again...
Well, when you work so hard, you're focused. You've got to focus on winning, and that's always been, you know, the focus of that UBC program clearly. And so it's hard. There's so much that comes into play besides your own effort, and you can only control your own effort. So definitely cool to see how much people care and how hard people have worked to get here.
And as for the Saskatchewan Huskies, they look like they'll be back next year. They'll lose Jamel Barrett and. They'll lose Rajon Shabbat and Trevor Nerdahl, but everybody else, assuming those fourth-year seniors come back, they'll be back. And
back in business.
Yeah, no reason to believe that Saskatchewan won't be right back in the mix next year.
And they're a very consistent team, and they've been contenders consistently, so it'll be exciting. You could easily have the same matchup next year, UBC and the Huskies again in the first or the gold bronze medal game. It can go either way.
Well, Cooper, that does it. Our year is over. Mm-hmm. We started with women's basketball way back in October for the Tigers, and finishing up here, women's and men's basketball, and now finishing up here with this bronze medal game and on SSN Canada. And special thanks to our friends at SSN Canada for giving us this opportunity. We had a lot of fun.
No, it's certainly been great.
And we will see you friends in October and the gold medal game. Western and Carleton, that will be on TSN 2, I believe on tape delay, There are a number of live blogs around the internet that you can follow the game on, including mine on sportsstream.ca if you want to. If you can't wait for the tape delay.
You want to know all the goods right now.
Yeah, you want to know the goods right now. So make sure you check those out. And we're about 2 hours away from the start of that game, so you can take some time off and get back for that in about 2 hours. Emma Cooper, thank you very much, young lady. Outstanding work.
Thank you, Bill McLean. Keep it real.
Her name is Emma Cooper. And thanks to Chris Keogh for helping us out with all this work as well. And thanks to everybody with the SSNCanada.ca family. Thanks to you, friends, for being with us throughout the weekend. And thanks again for all your emails. And hope you enjoy the broadcast coverage. Remember, tigerswebcast@gmail.com is your email. We will see you next year and the gold medal game coming up. And UBC are the bronze medal champions. Have yourselves an outstanding championship Sunday.